Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold. What was even the point of locking your door if everyone hid their key in the same place? Carl was starting to feel like his investigator life lacked challenge. The house smelled like incense, the kind that reminds you of the good Lord, of peace. Religion was very influential throughout Quebec many years ago. Indeed, it was surprising that Carl did not come across a single chapel since arriving here. The perfect cookie-cutter Catholic family, most likely attending church every Sunday. Good Paul VI, appearing papal. His crooked fingers gave the impression he was about to bestow a miracle. The family's mother must have spent her days washing the filth off her kids' diapers. The empty cradle sent an eerie feeling down Carl's spine, as if minutes ago someone just grabbed the baby and made a run for it. Who knew that giraffes thrived in the North Pole? The craze for toys was stupefying. Love of religion and ancestors was rooted deep inside the hearts of Canadians of old, to which the Bedards appeared to be closely related. Jean-Luc Bédard had without a doubt been the closest man in the village to William Hamilton, otherwise known as Uncle Willie. Carl wasn't desperate enough to invade a village woman's privacy. Dreamcatchers originated from First Nations legends. They were used to trap nightmares. Carl smiled at the sight of the nicely protected garden. Hopefully, the Bédards had managed to dig every last potato out before the sudden snowfall. A true Catholic always strives to keep lowly temptations at bay. Obviously, Carl thought, someone in this house wasn't doing a good job at upholding the Holy Bible's teachings. An aging car was parked here. Carl could picture the notary's heavy sedan with a huge back seat large enough to fit the whole family. A steak alone cannot subdue a starving stomach. An appetite comes with eating. An axe, not too shabby. Carl felt he needed to protect himself. It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore. Never thought he would be dancing with the wolves. It was a classic Canadian house, except for the absent horde of kids that would normally be swarming about. Just one more move and White is checkmated. Game over. It seems the game was abandoned right before the final strike came down. Simone de Beauvoir, Claude Lévi-Strauss, Hannah Arendt, Roland Barthes. Carl was surprised by the literature filling this liberal-leaning bookcase. Could there really be intellectuals dwelling in this far-off land? The photograph was snapped not too far from here, Carl noticed. The couple seemed to be very good friends. The couple radiated something akin to lightheartedness, to freedom. Perhaps some people out there truly found a way to live happily ever after. A picture of Wilfred in his youth. Carl figured right away that the man must have been some kind of wildlife officer. Not a single weapon was left. All of them were gone.
Thank you.